So I said, one gray variety, Uniblanc. Even if you've got several varieties allowed in the cognac area to produce cognac, but in fact, 98% is Uniblanc. Okay, because since we've got the phylloxera coming from your country, sorry about that. Well, it was something quite complicated to manage here, but yes. So since these times, everything is grafted. So the roots is Vitis berlanderi coming from Texas, and the Aryan part is from Italy originally. We call that Trebbiano Bianco di Modena. Okay, and so the French use the word Uniblanc because you know the French are very, very proud and they used to change every name because they would like to Francize it. But yes, at the beginning it's Italian, American, and we've got this beautiful variety who is able to produce very, very acidic wine. And this is important. Perhaps you will try some berries because we missed to pick at everything with the machine. It's quite acidic. Even it's acidic because, as you can see, the density of vine per hectare is quite low. If you come back from Bordeaux area, you've got a lot of chateaux where you've got 10,000 feet of vine per hectare. Here it's not 10,000, it's 2,000 and 500 feet per hectare. So not a lot of vine. The space between two ranks, it could be 3 meters. The space between 2 feet, 1 meter and 20 centimeters. That means that you give to your vegetable a lot of place for the roots and for the leaves to synthesize, photosynthesize. And this allows us to produce until 6 kilos of grapes per feet. So it's a lot, it's a kind of monster, but this is our goal. It is not to produce more alcohol because our grapes are not really, really sugared. There is not a lot of sugar because you know that the curves of sugar and acidity are still opposite. So here we are looking for acidity because we need this acidity to let to keep our wine good all during the winter long without added any sulfites inside. This is one of the rules for cognac making. You can't stabilize your wine with sulfites because if you boil a wine containing any sulfites, you will synthesize what we call hydrogen sulfur, which smells old eggs. So you can't. So we need the acidity to help us to keep the wine stable during the winter because we don't want it to turn vinegar. And another thing is that the acidity of the wine will interact with the ionic charge of the copper of the steel. And this will allow us to create some new aromas because you will see that the newborn eau de vie cognac is not smelling grapes or wine. It's smelling pears, green apple, perhaps banana, stone fruit sometimes, but something else, and it's coming from this interaction. So we need a very, very low pH, level of acidity. Here this pH for the harvest was 2.9. To give you a clue, the lime juice is 2.5. So when I say acidic, it is acidic. And that's why you will never heard about a very, very good table wine made in cognac with our grape variety planted in this way, because it's not possible, in fact. If I would like to produce a good table wine, I have to remove all my vineyard and replant it with 10,000 feet per hectare to get a right density, to get concentration, more sugar in the berries, and extraction and everything.
How many hectares